Hello and welcome back. We have here data of employees with the date and their attendance. The sheets are named after the employees. You could in fact have any other type of data. For example, you could have date and expense. You could have date and marks of students. Any data. Now what the user wants to do is do a total of the data here in the different sheets, and you can have as many sheets as you like. So here also we have the counted data, and we want to now create a summary sheet . If you click on this, we will create here a summary sheet of all the employees with their attendance. So if we click on generate summary sheet, you get the data from all the worksheets. And of course you can keep on adding worksheets and you will get their data here. Similarly, you can sort this data. Once you have created a summary sheet, you can click and sort the data like this. Now we can automate this complete process by using VBA. That is how these two buttons have been created. They have been attached to two different subroutines or macros. So let's go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and let's have a look at the module 1. We define here, after naming a macro or a subroutine, generate summary, we define two variables, last row as long and WS as worksheet. We then define how the last row gets its data. We go to our summary sheet and clear the contents from A to B and the last row. The range A1 and B1 have these titles or headers. Now we do a looping process for each worksheet or WS in sheets. We say if the name is not summary, if WS.name is not summary, then it needs to get the name of the worksheet and place it in the last row plus one. That means in the next row after the last row. Similarly, it gets the value from range B25 and places it in the same row but in the column 2. We end the if and we loop again till all the worksheets are covered. That is how we generate that summary sheet. Now let's have a look at our sorting. So we'll go here to Project Explorer. We'll look at module 2. Again, we declare a variable. We say how it gets its data. And then we do a sorting. Now if you look at this code, it looks daunting. But it's absolutely not daunting. How do I get this? Except for a few lines which I change. So let's go to our Excel worksheet. Let's generate the summary sheet again. And you see this is not sorted now. What we do is we select this data. We go to the developer tab and we record a macro. And we can call this macro sort data. We can assign it a shortcut if you like here. We won't do it now. Store macro in this workbook. Description, sort summary sheet. And we click on OK. So the recording will start now. We have selected this already, so we go to data, and we click on sort, it's done. We go to the developer tab and stop recording. Let's click on the macros and click on sort data, edit, and let's see how it is recorded. And you can see here, so exactly what I showed you in my module 2, except that instead of a fixed range, I say A2 to B and last row. And finally, of course, I select the summary sheet and select some cell. In this case, I have selected range C1. This is pretty easy, isn't it? So sometimes when you find the code a little difficult, just record that and have a look at the code. Let's go here. I'm going to delete this now. Click outside, generate summary sheet, sort summary sheet. Now, how did I get these buttons? Let me explain to you on the basis of just the sorting. So let me generate the sheet again. Let's go to the developer tab, insert. Here I'll take the button here. I'll just click and drag, and it says which macro do you want to assign this button to. So I'll say sort data. Okay, I just right click on this and click here, and we can say sort data. Click outside, and now if I click on this, it should do a similar sorting like this button does, except that this button is more flexible because it takes the last row into account, which means if you keep on adding more sheets and getting more data in your summary sheet, this will always do the sorting properly. This will just do the sorting from here to here. So let's click on this, and there you see the data has been sorted. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.